Today we're going to create an Excel macro that's going to help us print specific worksheets by selecting them from a list. So we're going to create an ActiveX List Box that's going to include a list of all sheet names. We can select one or more Excel sheets, press print, and it's going to print them as one print job. Or we can send it to print preview and be able to view everything in one print preview screen and not separate ones. This video was inspired by Wayne from his comment on a previous Excel VBA video, which took a look at creating a combo box for easier worksheet navigation. Except this time, we're going to look at printing the selected sheets in one go, and we're going to use a list box instead of a combo box. I have a sample workbook here with different tabs. Some of them are chart sheets, and some of them are normal worksheets. So first thing I'm going to do is to insert an ActiveX list box. So let's go to the developer tab. If you don't have the developer tab activated here, just right mouse click anywhere on the ribbon, select customize the ribbon, put a check mark beside developer, and then click on OK. Inside the developer tab, let's go to insert. From ActiveX controls, select the list box, and then just draw it out where you want to have your list box. Excel automatically takes you to design mode. So what I normally do here is then go to properties, change the properties I need for my list box. I usually change the name of my ActiveX. I'm going to call this list box SH just so that I can recognize it easier later on. The other thing we need changed here is the multi-select property, because by default, only single selection is allowed, but I want to be able to multi-select. So I have a choice between select multi or multi-select extended. I'm going to go with extended because here you can also use the shift and control keys. Now let's talk about filling this list box. I don't want it to be connected to any cells. I want it to include the names of my worksheets. So I have different options. Either I can add a refresh button here. So anytime I add new sheets or I rename some sheets, before I come to print, I can click on refresh and it updates the names here. Or I can connect this to a special event. In this example, I'm going to connect it to the worksheet activate event so that anytime this worksheet is activated, so anytime I go out of the sheet and I come back here, the macro automatically runs. That macro is going to clear everything in this list, and then it's going to loop through each sheet in this workbook and add the name of it to this list here. So let's do that real quickly. We can bring up the Visual Basic Editor, or since I'm on this sheet right now, let's just right mouse click, click on View Code. This automatically takes me to the code window for this specific worksheet. So what I want from here is the worksheet object. Default event is selection change. That's not the one I want. I want the activate event here. So one thing I wanted was to clear that list box. So I'm going to go with me dot. So me is this object I'm in right now, which is the worksheet, list box sh dot clear. Okay, so before I add anything to this box, I want to clear what is in there. Otherwise, I'm going to be adding the sheets multiple times. Every time I click away and back, they're going to get added to that list. Then I want to loop through each sheet. So let's dim that. I'm not going to dim it as worksheet because I also have chart sheets here. So next, let's loop. So for each SH in this workbook, dot sheets, right? Not worksheets, sheets. And let's just close this. So next SH. So what I want to happen is to add the item to the list box. So let's go back to our list box object and let's choose the method add item. What I want to add? The sheet name, so sh.name. That's pretty much it. Now, if you're curious to find out what other methods, properties, or events are available for list boxes, you can check that out inside View in the object browser. If I just type in list box here, press enter. Right here, I can see the class list box. Here, I can see the different methods and properties and events associated with the list box. This one with the green icon, these are the methods. We already used the add item method and the clear method. These ones with the hand icon are the different properties. So we're going to be using soon the list and the list count property. These ones with the yellow lightning icon, these are the different events that are available for list boxes. Okay, so to find out more about any object in VBA, you can always come to the object library. So I'm just going to go back to the code. Now let's go and test this. First off, let's get out of design mode. Now to run my code, I need to run the activate event. Just need to click away, click back, and I get the list of tabs added here automatically. So let's just check this. If I just change this from chart 1 to just chart 4 and go back here, I can see that updated automatically in here. Okay, so we figured out how to fill this up. We want to be able to highlight different items, right, which I can do by holding down the shift key. I want to be able to print them. So I need something to trigger that event. I'm going to use a button for that. But first off, before I add the button, let's write the macro. So let's go back to Visual Basic, Alt F11. I'm going to add the macro to a module. So let's go to Insert, Module. By default, it added Module 1. Let's create a new sub-procedure here. Now let's think of the different variables we need right here. One variable is to loop through each name in this list. I'm going to dim I as long. You can also dim it as byte. Hopefully we don't have that many worksheets. Just to be on the safe side, I dim I as long. Now the other thing that we need is a string array, because I want to keep the sheet names in memory. The more sheets I've selected, the bigger it's going to get. So I'm also going to dim C as long. So I could dim this as byte as well. Next, for the sheet names, I'm going to dim sheet array, bracket open, bracket close, because I don't know its size, so I can't define it right here. And I'm going to dim it as string. Next, let's use with active sheet dot list box sh, and let's do end with right here. I need to loop through each item in the list box. So that was my I. So for I equals 0, now why 0? Because the first element inside the list box has an index of 0, right? Not 1, but 0. 2, now that depends on how many tabs I have. I could count them in different ways. I'm going to use the list count property of the list box. And then I have to make an adjustment of minus 1 because the index of the first item is a 0. So since I've opened this loop, let's just close it. So next I. As I'm looping, I need to check if anything is selected or not. If dot selected I, then what should it do? Let's close this with endif. Now comes expanding my array. Because I need to keep what it found in the first round, I need to not just redim it, but I need to preserve what it already found. And I'm gonna use sheet array C. To add it to my array, I'm going to use sheet array C equals dot list I, right? So that item is going to be added to my string array. And then I'm going to add 1 to my C variable. Before we do the print or print preview command, let's just make sure this part works properly. I'm going to go to view and bring up the locals window, because here we can really check if everything is working as we like. So I'm going to click F8 to step through this. I can see my variables created here. I and C have default value of 0. Sheet array is empty for now. I is 0, so it's running right here on the first item. It's not selected, right? So it's not going to go inside. It's just going to go to endif and run again. Second one, not selected. Third one is selected. It's going in. My I has an index value of 2. Remember, this was 0, 1, 2. Now let's see what happens to this. Sheet array, something is getting created. It got the name chart 4, right? So C now equals C plus 1. Next one is not selected, not selected. This one is selected. So C is going to get a 2. And my sheet array is going to have input form in there. Let's just put a stop here and run this to here and see what value we get. Our sheet array has 3 items in there, and those are the 3 items we can see right there, right? So that's perfect. Let's stop this. Let's remove our breakpoint. Now, all we have to do is add the print command or the print preview command. I'll do the print preview for now. Let's see if it works properly. So sheets array is sheet array, open bracket, close bracket, dot print preview. Let's just run this to test. That's my first tab. That was the chart tab. That's the second tab. And that's the third tab. So 3 out of 3 is all in one view, right? So if you wanted to print this out, you would do sheets, sheet array, dot print out. Okay, so that will print it out as one print job. I'm just gonna comment this out for now because I don't wanna print anything right now. The only missing part here is to add a button that's connected to that macro. So since my macro is in a module, I'm just gonna add the usual form control button. Click on this, click on OK, and let me just rename this. Select this, 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 and this. Click on print preview. I have 1 of 4 right here. Okay, so in the same way, you can attach your macro to an icon. If you wanna make it look a bit nicer, a bit more modern and fancier, click on insert, change the color as you like, and then right mouse click, assign macro, and assign the macro to your icon. So when you click it, it goes to print preview. One tweak you can add to this is to add a workbook open event to the This Workbook object. Now, because I'm using the Activate event to fill up my list box, the problem I'm going to run into is that if I save the workbook while I'm in that sheet where I have the list box and then I open it again, the list box is going to be empty because the Activate event is not going to run. It's only going to run if I switch my view somewhere else and then switch back. So what you might want to do is to add a simple selection code to this. I'm just selecting sheets 1, and sheets 1 is another sheet here. It's not the sheet where I have the list box. It's my introduction sheet. So this makes sure that to get to the list box, they have to click on the tab, which is going to run the Activate event. Now, if you happen to have your list box on the first sheet, you can switch to sheet 2 and then back to sheet 1. This way, you're going to run the Activate event. Now, you don't need this if you go with our original option 1, which was to use a button to fill up the sheet names. So that's how you can use an ActiveX list box together with Excel VBA to select the sheets that you want printed and print them in one go. If you like this video, click that thumbs up. And if you want to become more advanced in Excel, consider subscribing to this channel and joining our wonderful community here.